Data leap! Data leap! In here, out there. My name is Andrew from Data Leap. Thank you guys so much every single day for being you, being awesome, and tuning in. Today, we are going to talk about data literacy, really important topic, and I hope you stay until the end because we are going to talk about how I'm changing my own habits because of the information inside this article. Welcome to Forbes Fridays. It's Friday and Baymax is happy to see you. If you like him, give this video a like. Do you know what it means to be data literate? Having a good grasp on exactly how much your data is worth and how much you are worth as a product. You probably have heard of the point people make when they say if a product is free, you are the product. So what we are going to go over today, if Friday, on Forbes Friday, is a very interesting Forbes article from September 1st, 2020, why you should stop sending texts from your Android Messages app. What could this possibly be? Well, one thing I want to ask you first is, how do you like this position? Do you like me over here or do you like me over here? The normal amount of closeness. Either way, leave a comment down below. Subscribe and like this video. I always, always respond to each comment. You guys know this. Come on. Hit that nice, big, fat, red subscribe button. And now, here comes your Forbes Fridays. If there's a glaring issue with a widely used technology now undergoing a major upgrade, you'd think the glaring issue would be fixed. Well, apparently not. If you're an Android user, then Google either just has or is about to update your device's Messages app with its answer to Apple's iMessage. Dubbed RCS, or Rich Communication Service, this will update your phone's basic default messenger into a fully featured chat platform to compete with iMessage as well as WhatsApp and Facebook Messenger. So this is an obvious case of they did it, now we do it. But there's a scary twist coming up. Let's get some meatball up in here. Come here. We're doing Forbes Fridays. Forbes Fridays meatball. Okay. Oh, my glasses. Messaging has become a battlefield, with Apple and Google battling Facebook, both Messenger and WhatsApp, to be the go-to platform on your phone. There are few stickier apps than the one you use to chat with friends, family, and colleagues, and as new functionality becomes more commercial, ticketing, coupons, purchases, transfers, and ads, this becomes a real money spinner. As reported this week, ever more countries are becoming RCS-enabled. Recent updates have appeared in Argentina, Chile, Denmark, Italy, Norway, Pakistan, Poland, Portugal, and Singapore. Oh, gosh. Although RCS is being deployed by carriers around the world, it is Google driving the rollout. It needs to level the playing field with Apple. RCS is the long-awaited upgrade to the standard SMS capability built into our phones. SMS is a basic tech that is really best avoided. And unfortunately, RCS has not fixed one of its most critical issues. Putting animated stickers and easy-to-reach GIFs to one side, messaging comes down to a balancing act between functionality, security, and install base. The install base across the platforms from big tech, you know, Facebook Messenger, WhatsApp, iMessage, and Google Messages is clearly good. Albeit, Facebook requires an over-the-top service rather than the fallback to network SMS used by Apple and Google. Functionality is good across the board and getting better all the time, but on the security front, there's still a major difference. That's all the meatball that we can afford today. The original and still most universal global messaging platform is SMS, the standard text messenger available on GSM phones. Both Apple and Google use SMS as a fallback for those without iMessage, where Apple is concerned, or without the upgraded chat functions offered by Google, which are built around the new RCS tech. But RCS is not an iMessage equivalent. It's completely different and has a glaring issue. Android users should turn to WhatsApp or Signal instead of using Android Messages app. When you send an SMS, the data is encrypted between your phone and the cell tower. It can't easily be intercepted over the air as such, but that's simple network security. Once the SMS has disappeared into the network, it is open to interception. And given we text people on different networks and in different countries, your SMS can travel across a hodgepodge of different network servers and systems. Back in 2016, WhatsApp fixed this by defaulting to what's called end-to-end encryption. What it means, put simply, is that the message is secured with only the sender and recipient holding the decryption key. No one, including the network and WhatsApp, can see what you have sent. iMessage does exactly the same, as long as it's that blue bubble once you go green in SMS, and all bets are off. As you see the issue, Google has decided to adopt an updated SMS architecture to work with the carriers rather than providing Android with an over-the-top equivalent to iMessage. Your message is encrypted between your phone and Google servers, but that message can be decrypted en route. You're not the only one with the key. And if the message links in with other RCS deployments, then it's as unsecured as an SMS. You can control when iMessage uses SMS. You don't have that easy flexibility with Google Messages' use of RCS. As Google says, if your chat features are provided by Google, but your recipient's RCS service is with another provider, then your messages are routed through Google's RCS backend and then routed into your recipient's RCS backend. Last year, Germany's SR Labs warned that deploying RCS as an SMS upgrade without a new approach to security exposes most mobile users to hacking. The researchers warned that the way in which Google and the carriers were deploying RCS would open users to impersonation, mimicking the number and IP address of a device, interception and tracking. RCS provisioning is badly protected in many accounts, the team said, allowing hackers to fully take over user accounts. And Google Messages does not implement sufficient domain and certificate validation, enabling hackers to intercept and manipulate communication through a DNS spoofing attack. The technical details don't really matter here. The fact is that either your messages are end-to-end encrypted or they're not. And while you probably think that most of your messages don't warrant security, we all send financial details, contact details, and other sensitive information over messengers. We use messengers to chat with work colleagues. We expect they're secure from prying eyes. Facebook and WhatsApp have both warned that end-to-end encryption is a necessary security measure to stop content falling into the wrong hands. Facebook even advocates the secret messages feature in its own messenger to mitigate the compromise of server and networking infrastructure used by Messenger, Facebook's included. Messenger isn't end-to-end encrypted by default, and users should switch to WhatsApp. RCS is even worse. At least Facebook is a single provider and doesn't push content outside its own control. Google is reportedly developing an end-to-end encryption upgrade for its RCS deployment. And when that's done, this advice will change and Android users will have an iMessage alternative. Until then, I strongly advise you to ensure your go-to messenger is fully encrypted. WhatsApp is likely your best option. It's ubiquitous and has all the features you need. It's also due a bunch of feature upgrades, including multiple linked devices, which will make it even better. But if you balk at the idea of Facebook accessing your data, albeit I'm not sure Google is a much better option, then go for Signal, the all-round best messenger available today. I can't vouch whether or not this was a Signal ad after all. I mean, Forbes has done this on occasion, but hey, thank you, Forbes, for the news. I'm going to go and switch off of Messenger, and until next time, stay safe, be data literate, continue educating yourself with the data. Thanks for listening. Hey, for this, I'm going to have a special secret for you. Next week, there's a special collab coming up with one of my favorite YouTubers on YouTube and a comprehensive guide on how to start data science from ground zero. I hope you'll be there with us. Subscribe if you want to catch that. Make sure to like this if you liked it, and see you guys next time. Peace.
Press 9 to hear more options. Press 0.
What are you talking about?